guys, and welcome back to HR Talks with Lish. I hope you're all doing well. It's been a while, hasn't it? I have not done a vlog in so long, so I thought, you know what, it's time to bring the vlogs back. But yeah, it's really good to be back. It's good to be back in a routine. I feel like I've just been living my best life this summer. I've literally been traveling. I went to Spain last month in July, went to Paris a week ago. Just trying to enjoy myself. Like, I think since COVID and since all those restrictions, this is the first summer that's not really, there's been like no restrictions, hardly. So I just thought, you know what, let me enjoy myself. I missed out on 2 years, so let's have fun. So yeah, I've just been doing loads of different activities with friends and family, and the YouTube schedule's been a little bit, you know, rocky, but we're getting back into that routine now. I'm here, I'm back, and I'm ready. I'm ready to give you the content that you deserve. So yeah, Paris, I actually have a vlog of Paris, which I'm going to be putting up next week, so stay tuned for that. But so many things have been happening since I've kind of like spoken to you properly. I have announced things here and there, but like I haven't fully announced certain things. So one of the big announcements is that I have been promoted, guys. I've been promoted. I am a performance and career management partner at my company, and I have not even been at my company 2 years yet. It's 2 years next month in September, but it's like, it's not even been 2 years yet, and I've been promoted twice, which for me is just like, I can't believe it, to be honest. I'm really happy about the achievements that I've made at this age. I'm 24 and I'm basically a HR business partner, and it's still sinking in for me. I haven't started my role yet. I do start my role in like the end of September, start of October, hopefully, because at the moment the HR department at my company are going through a global transformation. So basically like loads of new roles have come up out of this because we're trying to be more agile in the way that we kind of approach how we do things in the business. So a lot of the roles are going to be more specialized, hence why I said I'm a performance and career management partner, not just a general HR business partner, because I'm going to be specializing in performance and career management, hopefully more so in career management, because that's basically the path I'm trying to go down in terms of my career, and that is what I would love to focus on. So hopefully I can do like a certified accredited coaching course just to gain more skills around that, because I do want to get into coaching in general. Also, if you haven't seen my post on the community, I have started trialing out coaching. I have a few free strategy calls that I've set up with some of my subscribers this week that we're going to be going through. I just want to open up like the services that I provide and offer to you guys, because I feel like there's just so much more that can come out of HR Talks to Leash. There's so much more that I can do to provide help and support. So yes, you can get loads of information from the videos that I post, but there are opportunities now and also in the near future for one-on-one sessions with me, so that we can have a more personalized approach and I can really get to know you guys. So yeah, so much more to come from me, guys. Happy with the progress that has been happening so far in this year, in 2022. It's been a good one. And yeah, I'm still loving all of the support and the love from you guys in the comments, on LinkedIn, on Insta, on my TikTok as well. Like, it's been great so far this year, and there's still so much more to go for the year. But I am trying to get myself back in a routine now that summer's nearly over. So I'm literally just getting myself organized, and that's what this vlog's basically going to be all about. You seeing me just getting myself organized, doing my workout. So I'm doing a challenge at the moment. I've set myself a challenge to work out twice a day for 7 days, and so far we're on day 4, so you'll see a little bit of that in this vlog. You've probably already seen a bit of it because I've probably shown you that already. I'm gonna be working, still a HR administrator, so I'll just be showing you like the day-to-day tasks that I'm getting up to, and I'll just talk about some of the projects I'm working on at the moment. And then I done some meal prep yesterday, so I'll show snippets of that. So yeah, hope you enjoyed this vlog, guys, and I'll see you in a sec. So guys, this is the first call of the day that I'm about to hop onto now. But this call basically was a call where I needed to clarify a few things to
a employees assistant that's going to be starting in our UK business unit very soon, and they just wanted to clarify a few points with me based on how things work UK wise, because obviously within our company is a global international company and we use the same softwares across all of the business units that we have. So they have quite similar softwares to us, but it works a little bit differently in the UK. So the individual's assistant, who's still going to be working as their assistant from that other country, but the individual is transferring over to the UK, needs to understand how it works from our perspective. So I'm literally just kind of clarifying specific points, any questions that they have about the transfer. And I think it's really good to, like, when things are not as clear, and you need some clarity on a situation, having a call with somebody is like one of the best things that you can do, because sometimes when you go back and forth on emails, it's a little bit, it can get a little bit confusing, or sometimes the message of what you're trying to say might not come across as clearly as it needs to. So now we've moved on to the afternoon, and I am very, very, very busy when it comes to new starters and having to sort out all of the onboarding processes for these individuals before they start in September. We've got so many new starters in September, and me alongside my colleagues have been really working to try and make sure that everything's put in place as smoothly as possible for this. So that's what I'm actually working on at the moment. I am just ensuring that, like, we have sent out the contracts, we've updated the systems. We've got a big graduate cohort starting in September, which is why our onboarding is quite significant in September, because other months are not so significant and we haven't had like a massive intake of people for a while. So it's going to be big, and I've got like 3 different onboarding sessions to do within the first week of September, which is crazy. But yeah, so as I've mentioned before in previous videos, being an HR administrator, I am in charge of the employee life cycle. So it's very important that we are liaising with the candidate if they've got any questions or concerns. We're making sure that they're linking in with their managers beforehand so that they've had a chance to speak to their manager, potentially just to get a feel of what it's going to be like when starting the company. We also make sure that the managers are aware of their responsibilities within the process. So it's not just on HR to make sure that it's a smooth process, but the managers as well. And when we are doing this process, we need to make sure that people in other departments are also updated on the changes, as it's important for them to know the changes. So for example, finance need to know for headcount, IT need to know to make sure that the equipment is ready and set for the new starter when they arrive and start in the office. So there is a lot of work to be done. I've also had to liaise with managers as well, because sometimes some managers are in different countries, so they don't 100% understand the actual process in the UK of the onboarding. So we've got to make sure that it's clear to them so they understand what's going on. I'm also working on a few projects as well. So there is a project that I'm working on at the moment within our diversity and inclusion, which is, it falls within identity. So we're working with specific companies to help us devise a plan of action for what we want to achieve within the next year when it comes to our identity pillar. So I'm doing a bit of research on that at the moment. And there's also other things that I've really got to do. That there's so much stuff on my to-do list, guys. Like, honestly, I've always got things to be doing. But it's about finding the time to do them and making sure that they can be done. So another thing that is still on my list, but I haven't been able to do yet because I've just been faced with certain issues and dilemmas that I've had to solve. As you can see right now, like, I'm literally stumped because I'm reading something and I'm just like, whoa, what am I doing? I sometimes have to think and then process what the best way to move forward is. And with these new starters, there's been a few hiccups in the processes, so literally just been trying to get my head around that. But as I was saying, other things on my list to do are we need to promote a new application that has been launched via one of our benefit providers. So our private medical health provider launched an app and it needs to be promoted to the rest of the business, and I want to do this in the best way possible. So that's something that's on my list to do. Also, we had a talk with a university recently. So we basically presented the company and said everything about us, what we do. We had a few graduates talk about their experiences because we wanted to get some more people engaged in the graduate scheme before we closed the scheme for the year. So I've got to just do a little bit of editing, fine tuning on that video so we can put it on our internal platform so the rest of the business can see what we're trying to do when it comes to the workforce of the future. And yeah, there've just been a lot of things happening at the moment within my role. Quite a busy time, even though it's the summer period, you'd think it's not gonna be that busy because in the summer, everyone's on holiday. So it's, don't get me wrong, it hasn't been like overly busy, but it's been busy. I think just because of so much new starters who are gonna be joining the company and just getting that sorted. And then on top of all the other projects and things that I now have time to focus on, it means that I'm a bit more busier. But yeah, that is my afternoon just summed up.